Off to Ponty for pub quiz now on 2W, and as it's chaired by the lovely Frank Hovis, you can expect some strong language and a couple of stains, I think.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We're on our way to Pontypridd, birthplace of not one, but two musical legends. Yes, not only is it the hometown of opera singer Sir Geraint Evans, the man whose huge Falstaff brought pleasure to millions, but also Tom Jones, the man who's only got to open his mouth for hundreds of women to fling their knickers at him. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll give you Pontypridd.
From the California shore to New York City, the beat don't ever stop.
Coming to you from the Monster's Arms in Pontypridd. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Frank Hovis. Let's meet the contestants. Steady. Two teams, ladies and gentlemen, two teams. The ladies and the gentlemen, they are in fact married to each other, but we split them up. We don't want any nonsense like that. All right, touching and mucking about like that. So there we are. We have Dawn Caroline, Steve Rhett. So, and of course, I mustn't forget, last and definitely not least, our lovely new scorekeeper, the very lovely Candy, ladies and gentlemen. Now, before we get started on the quiz, Rhett is an unusual name, isn't it, Rhett? I've not heard that one before. How did you get that name, Rhett?
Have you never seen Gone with the Wind? Have you heard of Gone with the Wind?
Heard it, smelt it, yes.
Yes. Which is a bit like me.
Is that where the name came from?
Yes. And my brother's Ashley as well.
Oh, right. So what, your mother a fan of?
Extreme fan.
Well, you see, that is a coincidence, is it? Because I'm also named after a character from Gone with the Wind.
Go on.
All right, Frank Lee. No, you never actually see him. You know, he's a minor character, but when he says Frank Lee, my dear, I know, that's me. Question one to you, Steve. If the Spanish Inquisition had got you in for questioning, which of the following might they use? A tumscrew, a thumbscrew, or a bumscrew?
Ooh, a hard question, huh?
It is a hard one.
Thumbscrew.
It's the right answer. Yay! Well done, Steve. Thumbscrew. A tumscrew is something I just made up, and I think you all know what a bumscrew is, don't you? Hey? You know, don't you, Dawn?
Not telling, sorry.
You're not telling? I wonder why. Right, continuing our Spanish theme, ladies and gentlemen, which of the following is a famous Spanish bullfighter? Is it A, Enrique Ponce, B, Joselito Pimp, or C, Jeffries?
Ponce.
Is the right answer, ladies and gentlemen. Right answer. He's doing well. Enrique Ponce was in the newspapers earlier this year after being repeatedly tossed by a bull. I know. I'm not a fan of bullfighting, but you do have to admire their spunk, don't you? On this occasion, anyway. Next question. This is for you, Dawn. What is the Dickin Medal? Is it A, a medal awarded to animals that have performed courageous acts, B, a medal awarded to people that have rescued animals, or C, a medal awarded to porno stars for putting their dick in? Hey? No, it's not. I made that last. I couldn't resist.
A.
It's the right answer. Yay! Well done. Well done, Dawn. Yes, it's a medal awarded to... The first winner was a pigeon called Winky. This is true. He saved the lives, Winky did, saved the lives of a bomber crew that crashed in 1942. He flew back to tell everybody where they were. A few days later after the rescue, they held a banquet and they toasted Winky. Okay. I think that's a bit harsh, but fool whatever. If you want supply, Caroline, your first question. In Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, is the name of the house elf Jobby, Dobby, or Mr. Blobby? What is it? Jobby, Dobby, or Mr. Blobby?
B.
B. Dobby. It's the right answer, yes. Well done. Well done. Yes, Dobby. Mr. Blobby, of course, featured in Noel's house party. Rumours that Mr. Blobby and Noel were having a torrid homosexual affair are false, ladies and gentlemen. The fact that Mr. Blobby looked like a giant diseased penis is neither here nor there. It certainly wasn't up Noel Edmonds' arse, anyway, I'll tell you that. So, at the end of that opening round, what are the scores, Candy?
OK, the gents have 2 points and the ladies also have 2 points.
Well done, everybody. Well done, everybody. Let's have a poem now. Wales is the land of poetry, ladies and gentlemen, and as I entered Pontypridd today, I felt this one come to me. Here it is. A large-breasted girl from Pontypridd said, "My bra is so tight I can't breathe." So she undid the strap, and her bosoms went slap and killed an old man underneath. Hey? R.S. Thomas. Oh! What a good link, because we're in for raspberries now, ladies and gentlemen. So much for poetry, now it's time for music. Earlier on, I went out and asked some people in Pontypridd if they would like to perform a well-known song in an unusual way. So I want you to watch the following video clip and tell us what song you think they're performing. Ladies first, what do you think that was?
I think it is. We'll keep a welcome in the hillside.
All right, gentlemen, what do you think?
We agree.
Yes.
You think the same thing? Have you got it written down?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, otherwise, you might just be agreeing with it. You got the right answer, but you have got it written down. Very good. It is indeed. We'll keep a welcome up the backside. Up the hillside. Marvellous. There we are. On we go, on to the next round, which is the first of the quick-fire rounds. 10 questions. Aye. So it's first, if you think you know the answer, make a sound after I've asked the question. Here we go. First question. Where in Candy's body is her gluteus maximus?
Ass. Ass.
Ass? Ass? You be a bit more specific than that, Rhett.
Buttock.
Very good, he's absolutely right. Very, very good. Yes, in her buttocks, the gluteus maximus is the largest of Candy's buttock muscles, and it is there, I checked before we started the programme. Next question. In Iran, recently, a woman gave birth to a frog. True or false?
False.
Do you want to reconsider?
Can I phone a friend?
No. You haven't got any. No. That's so cruel. That's so cruel. And I don't mean it. I'll make it up to you afterwards, if that's all right with you. Yeah, no, it's true, in fact. According to Iranian newspaper Eternad, a tadpole grew inside the body of an Iranian woman and she gave birth to a frog which displayed human characteristics. Even if it was a frog, you know, we shouldn't be surprised because in France, women give birth to frogs every day of the week, don't they? Hey, come on! Hey! Next question. The official Latin name of the ornamental bramble is Rubus Cockburnianus. Rubus Cockburnianus, the official name of the ornamental bramble, true or false?
False.
False. No, it's true. It's true. It's absolutely true. I couldn't believe it when I discovered it in the big encyclopedia. True, there's also an evergreen perennial called Just Stick Your Cock in Here. There. No, if you look at RHS Big Encyclopedia, they're all there. It's quite astonishing. You can't make it up. I have tried. No, okay. Next question. Anagram. Anagram now. This is the anagram. Who or what is Mojo Nest? To the camera. In this game, it's the quickest, not the longest, I have to say.
It's a money game as well. Tom Jones.
Tom Jones, let's have a look.
It's the right answer.
It's the right answer. Next question. Maths. Maths question. Get your thinking caps on. How many metres in a metre?
One.
Yeah. Okay, at the end of that round, that's up the scores from Candy.
The ladies have 4, but the gentlemen are storming ahead with 7 points.
Sorry, Candy, can you... I've got my hands full. Can you just get the car keys out of my pocket? Thanks. Just that pocket there. Just in there. That's it. Just put your hand... That's right. No, a bit further. A bit harder. Just push it right. That's it. No, careful with me, small change. Hey, it's not the key. Wait. No, a bit further. A bit. Oh, Candy. I've just remembered. The key's in the other pocket. Lovely, isn't it? Very beautiful. Do you fancy a walk up the hill? Strawberry Hill walk, don't they? Be great. No, you've got to wear right clothes for walking in hills. You know, around here, quite dangerous, you know. No. Oh, Christ, sorry about that. But you are wearing the right clothes. Something very tight. Something really tight, that's right. Because your floppy, loose clothes, they'll just get caught on shepherd's crook or a ram's horn, something like that. So you dress well for it. I think we should go for a stroll. Ah, I'll just finish me. Whatever this is. Sorry. You want some of my bacon?
Oh.
Okay, we're going to get physical now. With the pub quiz equivalent of netball, salted peanut ball. The idea is the gentlemen trying to get their peanuts into the ladies' glass, and the ladies trying to get their peanuts into the gentlemen's glass. Put on the peanut goggles, please, if you will.
I'm not trying to make us look stupid, eh?
No, why would I want to do that? 30 seconds to get as many peanuts as you can in the opposing side's glass. Off you go now. Goggles off, let's have a look. Well, what do you think? I would say, ladies and gentlemen, that the gentleman's glass there has more peanuts than the ladies' glass. Yes. 2 points to the ladies. Well done, ladies. You handle the nuts well. You must have experience. Hey, come on. Move on to the team round now. The team round. Ladies, 3 questions for you. Your first question. Which member of the aristocracy with a face like a horse, and I'm not talking about Camilla Parker Bowles here. Which member of the aristocracy with a face like a horse could mate a king?
Yeah.
Take your time, time's up.
No,
what do you
no,
think?
No.
Throw it to the gentleman, no. What do you think?
A knight?
Well, Johnson! It's a knight from chess, I don't know if anybody can play chess, I had chess lessons once. I didn't quite get the hang of it though. We started off, we sat there and he said, right, now before you do anything, Frank, think very carefully about where you're going to move your pawn. You know, and after half an hour I said, well, I think it's all right under the bed, you know. Okay, next question for the ladies. Getting a piece of this is very easy. Getting a piece of this is very easy. What is it?
Action?
No. Gentlemen, any ideas?
Piss.
Polite society where people like me hang out. The expression is a piece of cake. So around here it's a piece of piss, is it?
It is that, this one.
A piece of frozen urine. All right, you can have a point for that. I give him a point. Well, all right. Come on now, girls. Come on. Anyway, last question of the team round. Ladies, what would Jamie Oliver do with crabs?
Hey. Steam them?
Yeah.
Get some cream from the doctor.
Oh! Maybe that's what he'd do. I don't know. Well, actually, what I've got is he'd dress them. Dress crab. But I think steam, I'll accept that. Yeah, I think I have a point for that. Why not? Why not? Right, gentlemen, it's your team round now. What can be teeth, balls, and Claudius? Teeth, balls, and Claudius.
Aye.
Very good. Very good. Eyeballs, eye teeth, and eye Claudius, the TV series, yes. Starring Derek Jacobi as Claudius, and Sean Phillips was Livia. The only thing I can remember from it is somebody said to Sean Phillips, Livia? And she said, no, my house is just around the corner. Next question for you. Gentlemen, if a music teacher asked you, so what? What would you say? Music teacher asked you, so what? What would you say?
It's far.
Oh, it's la. You're Amy Farr, so la. On the right track. But going to the wrong place. The answer was la. Oh, never mind. Next question. Your last question, team round. Gentlemen, if you had engaged the services of a prostitute in Rill and she charged £5, you'd be getting a raw what? Rill prostitute? Raw deal. Thank you very much. Here's the right answer. A raw deal, that's absolutely right. So we have I, La, and deal. Bonus point open to any of you. I, La, and deal. Can you rearrange those words or those sounds to give me the title of a smash hit pop song?
Delilah.
Delilah. Very good. Delilah by local boy Tom Jones, OBE. So at the end of that, can we have the scores from Candy? There you go.
Right, the poor ladies are on 9 and the men are still in front with 14 points. Yeah.
Just come to a charity shop. Looking for a little present for Candy, you know, something nice, something that'll turn ahead. Yeah, I think that's it. I'll take that, please.
Okay, all right.
Could you just sort of hold it up against yourself there?
Against me?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't think you're quite the same size, but you're both women, aren't you? So, oh, then that'll do. See?
Yes?
Okay. Have you got any pants?
Pants?
Yeah.
Men's pants?
Ladies' pants.
Oh. Ladies' knickers?
Yeah. I'll take them as well, anyway, just to be on the safe side.
Okay,
it'll be a kind of lucky bag. I'm sure something will fit. Right, a couple of days ago, I took myself off to Pontypridd Market and I put the following question to 12 people. Do you want to see me ring? Okay, now, gentlemen, how many people do you think said no? Ladies, how many people do you think said yes? Have a look at this. Sorry, Candy, just hopefully. It's a home video that got into the pile, isn't it? We had a few friends around the weekend, you know how it is. This'll be the... Sorry about that, I'm so sorry. This'll be the one. Have a look at this. Yes, I bought this lovely ring in a little shop in the market. I'm so pleased with it, I've just got to show it to someone. Would you like to have a look at my ring?
You what?
My ring. Would you like to have a look at my ring?
Yes, please.
Would you like to have a look at my ring?
No.
Would you like to have a look at it?
Not particularly, but I'll be seeing plenty today.
Will you?
Yeah.
What do you think you're going to be doing today?
Because I'm a staff nurse.
Do you like to have a look at my ring?
Oh, yes. Hi.
What do you think of that?
Nice.
Yeah?
What is it?
No. No, thank you.
Oh. Oh, it's very nice, actually.
Thank you.
No, you...
It depends on what it looks like.
You have a pee.
Go on, then.
No.
Go on, have a pee.
Up your ring.
Oh. Do you want to touch it?
No, thank you.
I wouldn't mind.
Yeah?
Yeah.
There it is. What do you think of that?
Fabulous.
Yeah? Very, very nice.
£3.
£3.
Not today, no.
I'm not
a little bit busy.
What about at the weekend?
Maybe, yes.
Yeah?
Yes, let's have a look. Very nice.
You like it?
Mm.
It's a beauty, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Do you want to touch it?
Go on, then.
Oh, that's lovely. Thank you very much for that. I enjoyed it. OK, so, ladies, how many said yes?
We think 8.
8 said yes, in your opinion. Gentlemen, how many said no?
6.
Is the right answer. No, it was in fact, 6 of 1 and 6 of the other, as a matter of fact. So 6 is bang on and 8 is bang off, I'm afraid. I'm sorry about that, but there you go. All right, well done. Moving on. We now have another quick fire round, ladies and gentlemen, so it's first to make a noise. The first professor of poetry in Wales was called Tony Curtis. True or false? Steve.
False.
No, it's true. He was appointed in 1994 at the University of Glamorgan, which is just up the road, isn't it? Oh, so there you go. Still on poetry. Which poet, all at once, saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils?
Wordsworth.
Yes, Wordsworth! Well done, Dawn. Well done. Wordsworth, yes, William Wordsworth, who, intriguingly enough, was born in a little town called Cockermouth in Cumberland. It's true. Next question, in 1755, the longest single-span arch bridge in Britain was built over the River Taff at Pontypridd by William Edwards. What's the capital of Sweden?
Zurich. I thought it was Switzerland.
You think Switzerland's the capital of...
No. Stockholm.
Yes. But for a moment, did you really think that Switzerland was the capital of Sweden?
I did.
Yeah. Specifically for you, you have 15 seconds to come up with 10 words starting with B. Starting now.
ball, basket, bum... Bridge, barbecue, birds, potato.
So
it's not as easy as you think.
No.
Banana.
Hey. It's not.
Bungee.
No, you can have a point. You can have a point for the effort, certainly. Bum and barbecue. What happens around at your house, Rich? What does happen? Next question. Human beings cannot urinate on one leg. True or false?
True, they can.
They can urinate on one leg?
Yeah.
Of course it's true. I've done it many times.
Normally this one.
Next question. What has opera singer and local boy Sir Geraint Evans got in common with the Marx brothers?
They've both got false moustaches.
Well, you might as well say that they're all dead as well. They've both got face. Yes, Rex.
I answered.
Hang on, hang on. No, you answered, but it was wrong, you see. It was wrong.
I think it's a night at the opera.
Oh, he's bang on the money, ladies and gentlemen. Very good. Dawn, you have 15 seconds to come up with 10 words starting with S. Starting now.
Slippery, snake, slipper, slide, sex, stone, shoe, sock, sugar, shearer.
Time up. Slippery. You were looking at him as well when you said slippery sex. And you used to go out with him, didn't you? And then you married that gentleman. And that's maybe why. The sex was too slippery, ladies and gentlemen. Last question in the quickfire round. If I've been touching a lady's uvula, where have I been touching her? Drop me in the car park around the back of the pub. Uvula. Come on, somebody. Audience, help.
In Pontypridd.
You don't know Pontypridd.
No.
It's the mouth or the throat, isn't it? Here we are. The uvula is the fleshy extension of the soft palate above the throat. I won't tell you what I touched her uvula with. A private matter between really, her and me. Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of that quickfire round, let's have the scores, please. Kendra.
The ladies are behind with 11, and the gentlemen are still in front with a very good 18. Oh.
Okay, now we're going to see another visual thing. We're going to see some people describing something that's actually quite familiar, but they're describing it in an unusual way. What is it that they're describing? Have a look at this.
Dark. Dirty.
Oh, dry, is it?
Dry?
Is it? Wet, sorry, wet.
Wet.
Well, by what I can hear, there is a certain degree of wetness down there, yes.
Deep, very warm.
Oh, black hole of Calcutta.
Right. He's quite small too.
Covered in dust.
Full of singing people.
200 or 300, depending on what shit they're on.
They might have watched a few episodes of Snow White and the Seven Dwarves.
It's warm, it's damp.
Yeah.
It's covered in dust, that one woman said. I wonder what that can be. Hold your boards up, let's see what you get written down. Coal mine. Right, let's have a look. Let's have a look.
Well,
let's have a look. Right, what have you done? Oh, no. Coal mine, well done. 2 points. Yay! Well, can we have the final scores? Because that was the very last scores now, please. Yeah.
Right, okay. The ladies had 13 and the men. One with 18 points.
Yay! I'm so sorry. I'm on the side of the women. I'd like to be on the front of them, but never mind. That's, so, I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry. No, it is indeed. The gentlemen have won. So for the winners, it's free drinks, and for the losers, you're paying for them. Very good. Yes. That is just about the end of the programme, but now, just before we go, some breaking news. Apparently, a waiter from Rill, yes, who was caught wiping his bottom on the tablecloths at the restaurant where he worked, has been arrested and charged with arson. I'm Frank Hovis. This has been Pub Quiz, coming to you from the Malta's Arms in Pontypridd. Thank you very much! Well done, well done.
We had to let the boys win. Otherwise, we don't get our own way when we get home.
All in good taste, I don't know. That was the height of my night, that was.
Oh, brilliant, really. Unexpected, yes.
Well, I'm pleased with the result, Frank, I really am, and I also feel if the quiz had gone on longer, we could have answered more questions.
Well, you know I love you, Ken. I've made that clear, haven't I? I love you, Ken. You know, we had a good show last night, and I was just wondering if... God, just one little kiss. Just one. Just a little. Kiss him. Eh?
Okay.
Oh! Right, right. Sorry, Candy. It was the bacon. It was the bacon at breakfast. I'm so sorry. Yeah. Oh, I do apologise. Oh, yes.
Frank and Candy back at the same time next Friday night on 2W in the Boar's Head in Brecon.